Vsauce, I'm Jake, and I hope that you are healthy, you're taking care of yourself, you're safe, and that you're considering the safety of others. What we are experiencing currently, at least in our lifetimes, is an unprecedented event. You know, years ago, I made a video about what a pandemic would be like in the present. This was based on the fictional outbreak from the game The Last of Us, and what we're experiencing now is very much real. If you go to healthmap.org, you can see a time lapse of how COVID-19 spread and just how quickly it did. For an even more in-depth look, the Systems Science and Engineering Department at Johns Hopkins University created an interactive map of the world where you can go country by country and see the number of cases. In the bottom right is a chart that represents the exponential growth of COVID-19. And if you've ever been curious about what exponential growth means and how it relates to pandemics, well, I cannot recommend highly enough 3Blue1Brown's video on the topic. It is incredibly informative and a wonderful insight on what is currently happening. But with everyone staying at home right now, I thought it would be good to bring back a show that we haven't done in years. One where we go and explore the internet together and hopefully show you some websites that you can spend some time with. So sit back, relax, and let me show you some dongs. Things that you can do online now, guys. Explore.org is a website that lets you experience the world around you from the safety of your own home. Shout out to my mom for sending this to me. Thanks, Mom. It has a myriad of live webcams where you can watch everything from kittens to the Santa Monica Beach here in California, an elephant park in Africa, or some penguins. After you've gotten your fill of wildlife, get your fill of art at the Wolfman Museum of Art. This site is amazing. It is a wonderful place to get lost, and there is so much to explore. For example, why not venture into the Bob Ross Arts and Crafts Center? There, you can make some 8-bit art or watch every single episode of The Joy of Painting. Or why not go into one of the art galleries? Let's try Gallery 3. They have an entire section of old radio broadcasts and live radio. I'd highly recommend checking Gallery 4 that has image collections from the Met and the Art Institute of Chicago. Wolfman Museum is part point-and-click adventure, part exploratory paradise. But instead of just looking at other people's art, create your own with people all over the world on malmal.io. Here you can see what other users across the globe have drawn. Join in and draw with them. Or you can create your own drawing board and theme it like this. Now that is art. I wonder how much it would sell for at auction. To get a sense for that, play the auction game. It shows you an image of a piece of art that was sold and you guess how much it was sold for. Let's see, I'm gonna guess $1 million. And I was incredibly wrong. Okay, I'm feeling good about this one. 500,000. Okay, well, I obviously have no understanding of the art world, so I'm gonna switch creative careers and try my hand at soundscape.world. If you want to zone out or have some pleasant ambient music playing in the background, you can create your own. Click on the soundscape you want to start with and then choose your rhythm, harmony, bass, melody, and extras until you create something like this. And keep that new tune playing in the background while we explore the rockets of Earth. You can browse by lift class, country, manufacturer, active rockets, reusable rockets, and rockets rated for human travel. Once you find what you're looking for, you can find out details like its maximum lift capacity to different orbits, how much the rocket costs, its launch history, and photos of said rocket. There is also a really cool compare feature to see how two different rockets stack up next to each other. Now, if you're really bored, why not learn a useful skill like speaking backwards with this phonetic reverser? Type in what you want to say, reverse it, and...
The work art.
I'm gonna leave you with two more things. The first is that if you wanna know more about COVID-19, how to protect yourself, how it got started, what the implications are around it, well then you should watch these two videos. One is by In a Nutshell and the other is by Mark Rober. I'll link to them down in the description. They really are fantastic and they do a much better job than I could of explaining the situation. And then the last thing is, dongs are all about doing things online now. But what about doing things in real life? Well, for that we have the Curiosity Box by Vsauce. Michael, Kevin, and I, and the whole Vsauce team, it's a quarterly STEM subscription box filled with books and t-shirts and video games and physics toys and puzzles and experiments. And it's something that we're very passionate about. We spend a lot of time working on this. And it's not only a great way to support Vsauce outside of watching our videos, but it's a great way to support your brain and the brains of others, because a portion of the proceeds from every sale of the box goes to Alzheimer's research. I think actually by the end of this year, we should be close to $200,000 in donations, which is fantastic. So if you want to join the Curiosity community, it's curiositybox.com. Check it out. I hope you really love it. We Love it a lot. Oh, I don't want to spoil too much, but I do want to show you one product, which is the Calibron 12. Now, this is a puzzle that Michael himself has said.
I'm being totally serious. It is the only puzzle that I own that I have yet to solve.
It really is tough. I've had a lot of trouble with this guy, but it was made by Thomas Edison's son, Theodore Edison, in 1933. And there was only a couple hundred made. We found the original patent and we remade it, doing all the measurements, everything, even the same material. The pieces are made of Bakelite, just like they were back in the day. So that is one of the products in this box. I hope you love it, because I love you. And, as always, thanks for watching.